Its ambition is commendable, but what is marketed as a story told from the point of view of Till's mother, Mamie Till-Mobley, gets lost in broad strokes. The tragic story of the abbreviated life of Emmett Till, the 14-year-old black boy brutally murdered in a racially motivated crime in Jim Crow era U.S.A., is hardly obscure. The abject cruelty of his death, and the judicial travesty that followed, remains irresistible to storytellers of all stripes. ABC's new anthology series Women of the Movement is a recent addition. It's a fact-based drama that ostensibly aims to center Till's mother, Mamie Till-Mobley, Adrienne Warren, who devoted her life to seeking justice for her son, and it's a worthwhile challenge. Despite how well-chronicled Till's death has been, his mother's story isn't as established in mainstream consciousness. But while Women of the Movement's ambition is palpable, it's a missed opportunity as a story told with broad strokes, stifled by lack of a singular, authoritative voice. Emmett Till was murdered just days after he left Chicago to visit relatives in Mississippi during the summer of 1955. His crime, allegedly flirting with a white woman. Tortured and killed in the dead of the night, his body was thrown into the Tallahatchie River. The murder was a case that drew international interest, sparking what became the civil rights movement. As the title suggests, Women of the Movement is not about humanizing Emmett Till, but nor is it quite the requiem for Mamie Till-Mobley that's its commission. Whereas Ryan Coogler's Fruitvale Station strove to engender empathy for Oscar Grant, before an encounter with police led to his death, which was saved for the very end, Women of the Movement unfolds primarily after Till was murdered. It may be marketed as a story told from the perspective of Till's mother, but she's ultimately part of an ensemble cast of familiar names and faces, and, at worst, she takes a back seat to the points of view of its male characters, including the reporters and civil rights activists from across the sea. In the few moments spent with Emmett, he's portrayed as a bright-eyed talker with an infectious smile, and an incessantly curious mind, a fearless kid ready to take on the world, even if naively so. The knowledge of what tragic fate lies ahead for him, cutting a life of potentially great promise criminally short, makes his expressive joy sadder to watch. And in the decades following his murder, until her death in 2003, Mamie continued to tell her son's story, which still haunts the American South.